Hi everyone, my name is Rajashekhar. Welcome to my channel. This is another complete workflow of Unreal Engine 5.5 using CAMSIS program. We're skipping on the 5.4 version though. We're directly getting into the latest version. Through this video, I would like to send a quick feedback or a request Unreal Engine tech team to come up or do something about the Unreal Engine DMX lighting system though. Although there had been a lot of performance and features implemented across the version, it could be your open patch tool or the looks of DMX library and whatnots, but still what we need is a haze for the DMX lighting. It looks flat and it lacks realism. I'm sure the team is working on it. Wish we had a toggle like thing which would enable haze for the lighting, because that could be system intensive. With the toggle button, you can either turn it on or off. The smoky, the haze would really add beauty to the DMX lighting. Looking forward to it in the future versions. Well, let's get started. Unlike my previous videos, I've slowed down a lot, especially when the navigation happens, and the repetitive ones are sped up. This is what we're going to try to come up in today's video. We'll begin by launching Unreal Engine, head to Film, Video, Live Events, and choose DMX, give a name for your project, and start up. We have the default DMX map loaded. As you know, this map is all set, the lights are placed, and the moment you hit play, the light goes on and everything is programmed. We're going to use this map as a reference, and we are going to use CAMSIS program to control lights on this map. We are also going to save time by avoiding placing the lights. We're going to use the existing light setup. We'll begin by categorizing the outliner, and we'll get rid of the existing DMX library. We're going to create a fresh DMX library for you to understand the workflow. I'll also be showing you the important settings which needs to be done in Unreal Engine for it to communicate with CAMSIS program, and also the essential plugins which needs to be enabled in Unreal Engine. By default, it's there. Few needs to be enabled and restarted. That's it. Sit back and watch the screen for you to understand the flow. The Unreal Engine is restarted, and right now we are going to create DMX library from the top. You will find me adding functions for all the light groups. Just one set of functions will do. I'm also going to use a handout which I prepared, which has functions for all the lights. I'll be using ClayPaki for this demonstration. You can use any manufacturer lights of your choice. During this process, you'll find me pulling up CAMSIS to locate a function for a light type. That is just to show you how you can use CAMSIS to find functions of any manufacturer lights out there. So let's watch this process. Thank you. Now we are going to use CamSys program to patch the lights to corresponding lights and universe which was patched in Unreal Engine. Before that, I'll show you the website address where you can download the CamSys Magic Cube PC software. Once it's ready, I'll run the program and I'll show you the settings which needs to be done in CamSys for it to communicate with Unreal Engine. You'll find me patching lights in CamSys based on the address to which lights were patched in Unreal Engine. Please look closely on the screen for you to understand the workflow. Once it's patched, I'll proceed to group all the lights and then test it. Now that lights are grouped in campuses and they're tested, now we're going to proceed with programming. I would say a very basic programming here for all the lights, and I'm going to record corresponding group of lights on a fader for us to trigger them as required. The programming part takes a little bit of practice. It's all about changing different attributes and getting your desired look. Once you see this part, I would request you to have a lot of hands-on on programming so that you can get to play with different attributes and get the desired look you need. The programming part is done. Now let's load up an audio file. And before loading that into CAMSIS, the audio file needs to be placed in documents. You'll see the path on the screen right now. It can be MP3 or a WAV format. I would recommend WAV because it can be used both in CAMSIS and Unreal Engine. So the audio will be placed, and then I'll proceed to load the audio inside a timeline fader in CAMSIS, using which we'll match the keys based on the audio. You'll see the process right now on the screen. For some reason, the audio part of it, the playback of it, hasn't got recorded. So you'll just see the waveform on the screen at the moment. To get to know about the complete workflow of Timeline, there is a separate video on my channel which goes by the title Timeline version 2 workflow. Do check that out. Now that we have taken care of matching the DMX light cues to the music, we will now proceed to record these light into Unreal Engine using Take Recorder. You will see the process right now on the screen. The lights are now recorded into Unreal Engine using Take Recorder from Camsys. We can close the Camsys program. We'll proceed importing audio file inside Unreal Engine. We'll proceed adding camera angles for the entire sequence and prepare it for rendering. Now that we have taken care of camera positions, let's proceed with rendering. You will notice all the required settings for the render to happen. Once it's rendered into a sequence of image, you can use your video editing program to make this into a video. Let's see the final output. That is a complete workflow of DMX sliding in Unreal Engine and CAMSIS program. Hope you found this useful. Do share this video to your friends and family who would be interested to learn DMX sliding basics and the workflow. I will also recommend you to check the community tab in my channel for you to see the various sliding demos which I'm offering you as template. The DMX template which I create would help you to save time and right away get into programming and testing the DMX sliding along with the CAMSIS show file which I provide to you. All you need to do is load up the Unreal Engine project file which I'll be sharing along with CAMSIS show file, and right away you can start programming and testing your lights. Thank you for tuning in. My name is Rajshekhar. See you all soon on another video.